All right, good morning, you guys. I just thought I'd share with you a couple things that are happening here. See this little friend of mine back here? This is my youngest daughter, Lucy. You probably, those of you that know me, have seen her. She's growing quite a bit. You say hi, Lucy? No, not quite. She's not doing so great. I think she's got another ear infection. As you can see, I am in my hiker. You see this here? Oops, not a very good shot here. Anyway, she's in the hiker. So I was just about to do a workout and here we are. So here is what I thought. You know what? This is real, right? This is reality as being a parent, is sometimes you just have to make it work, right? So she is 20 plus pounds. So I thought, you know what? She's really liked this hiker lately. Well, she loves hikes. But she loves being in her stroller. She loves movement in general. So I thought, why not show you a couple things that you can do if you just kind of have to make a change for your workout for the day. Obviously, you have the resistance of your child, whatever that is. I know I've showed you before a couple things with her little, her little cart where you roll her around. She likes to walk in. The girls, I think, push her in it more than she actually walks in it. But it's another great tool to use. All right, Lucy. So I thought I would just show you a couple things that you can do as a parent. Again, even if it's just a couple exercises, you can just repeat these and you can get a really great workout. So I am going to turn on some music because to me, sometimes you just need the extra motivation when you're going on not a lot of sleep, and when you got little ones who are not feeling so great and you just want to make it better, right? So you can multitask. Isn't that what it is being a parent? So let me get this set up here and you can see some options that you could have. Okay, so as you can see, she's back here, right? So let's start out. We're just gonna do some squats. So I'm just gonna turn around so you can see. Now I do a wider base. The reason it's wider is because as I squat down, she kind of tips forward, right? So I'm just trying to think of her back there. Now I'm just gonna count. So far I'm at, I think, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going for reps of 20 today. 10 more. 9, I got my toes turned out to the sides. I got my chest up, heels towards the center. Nice job, we got a few more yet. 4, 3, 2. Now I'm gonna pulse it at the bottom just because we can. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm starting with the bigger muscles just because I'm not quite warmed up yet. Now I'm just going to drive my knee towards the front. Now for me, this is just an active stretch. Now if you want to add a little more challenge to this, you can add a little lunge in the back, right? So lift, lunge, lift, lunge. Now obviously you got that balance, right? So I got her on my back as a challenge. So now if I was holding those weights, it'd be different, right? That center of gravity is lower, a little bit easier to balance versus having it higher up. Nice job, keep going. 4 more. 4, 3, 2. Other side, we're gonna start with that range of motion. Driving that knee so you're finding that balance. Lifting that knee up. Lift. 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 I'm going to go into that lunge, just like the other side. Now you choose that range of motion. So she's back there, happy as can be right now, because she's tired. Not sleeping real good. 10 more yet.
10. 9. 8. 7. Oops. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Woo. All right. So you did your squats. We had a knee raise with a reverse lunge, right? First two. Remember, we got those 20 reps. So I did 20 reps on each side for those lunges, right? All right, here we go. Now, leg raise to the side. So you're gonna lift, lower. This is our starting point. We're gonna add on to it. Lift and lower. Now you're gonna do a heel raise. Lots of balance. Keep that posture tall. Lower. 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 So I'm coming up onto the toes on that left leg, right? 10 more. 9. 8. 7. She's peeking around the corner. 6. 5. 4, 3, 2, right to the other side, right to that 20. Remember, start with that range of motion just to get that balance as you're switching sides, maybe adjusting the pack, maybe of the front carrier, whatever it may be, just finding that balance. Here we go. I lift. Lift for that heel raise. Lift. Again, we're staying nice and tall. Lower. 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 12. 11. 10 more. Woo. 9. Almost there. 8. 7. 6. 5. Woo. 4. 3, 2 more, 1 more, beautiful. All right, how's she look? Does she look happy? Oh, she does. Now, I'm going to add in a little something for those arms. All right, so I got some 20s here. Okay, so she's, again, just sitting tall. Even just working on that posture here, we're gonna do some hammer curls. Again, these are just 20s. Palms towards the center, just alternating. The only reason I'm alternating is because I wanna keep from that swing. Sometimes you need to do them both together once you get heavier with the weights, depending what that is for you. You start to swing the body. I try not to do that, especially with just keeping her on my back. That curl, elbows are close to the body. Even just having your back here is a good challenge. So 10 more each side. 10, 10, 9, 9, nice job. Keep going. 8, 8, 7, you having fun back there? 5. Oops. 5 on each side. Last 4 each side. Curl and lower. Girl, this is working so hard. 3. 2 more. 2 more. Curl. Curl. 1 more each side. Nice job. Beautiful. I'm setting one weight down. I'm going to grab that single weight. I'm going to hold it end to end here, okay? So make sure you have a nice grip. Again, posture nice and tall. I'm going to keep my feet hips to shoulder width apart, okay? And I'm just going to squat halfway down. I'm going to come up and then press, lower, squat, up, press, lower, squat. So again, this is a 20. It's a little bit heavier. That's why I just went with a single. Again, we're just making it work here. do have lighter weights. They're just not here. They're in my car, which is okay. It's just a good challenge, right? Push those glutes back on that squat. All right, Lucy. Quite honestly, I haven't been counting. Let's just do 10 more. 10. Press. Sometimes it's okay, right? Don't worry how many. You just feel that burn. And then you just do a few more, right? 8. 7. Feet, hips to shoulder width apart still. 6. 5 more. Keep going. 5. 4. That's okay. All right, now, little adjustment here. Okay, I'm gonna get my feet a little bit wider. So you can see they're under my hips. You can see real wide, right? I'm gonna come kind of right between them. All right, all I wanna do is push back through those glutes. So I'm getting into that cheek. So soft bend in that left knee, and I'm getting the glutes on the right side. And each time I'm just gently tapping my toes to the mat, to the floor, but I'm keeping that most of the weight on this left side. Again, just having her back there, yes, challenge, believe me. Keep going. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, get those glutes. Come on, right to it. Find that balance, right side. Soft knee. Squeeze that cheek. Remember, it's just a little wider than the shoulder width apart. So I'm not going straight back. I'm going a little bit to the side. Okay? A little bit wide. Just get to a different part of those glutes. Keep that soft knee. Most of that weight is on that right side. And that left toe is tap. It's very gentle. Barely touching. And see her come up a little bit each time. That's from my glutes. Just that little squeeze, that press back. Working that backside, getting into where the glutes and hamstrings connect. Keep going, you guys. You got this. Counts are probably off today. You know what? Like I said, it's all about moving the body here. Let's do 7 more. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. All right, I'm gonna grab that single weight back. Okay, I'm gonna get some space between my feet. This time I'm gonna get a little bit wider. Now as I do that, my toes are gonna turn out to the sides, okay? So this is towards the front. I'm gonna angle it out to the side. So heels are center, toes are wide here, okay? I'm gonna sit nice and low as best I can. I'm gonna stir like you're stirring a pot, keeping that height the same. We're gonna go 10 one way, 10 the other way. Okay, I just have that 20. Woo! 5 more in this direction. 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. Let's see. Alright, other way, same thing. All about equal, right? Keep that chest up and get biceps. Get shoulders, chest back, lower body. Almost there. 4. 2. Now, I'm just gonna take 60 seconds. We're gonna walk. Now again, this is very impromptu today. You know what? I'm just telling you, it's okay. Sometimes we feel like we have to have such a structured workout, and then we get all upset when it doesn't work out, right? It totally doesn't pay. You know why? Because we have enough stress every day, whether it's money, work, lack of work, maybe kids not getting along, whatever it is. Look at that. This right there is a gift. She's sleepy. She's getting tired. Mom's getting to move around. Got 10 seconds yet walking, you guys. I'm just taking my time, obviously, because I don't want to jar her around. It's her getting sleepy. Now, we did some lower body exercises, we did upper body, a little bit of everything. As you can see, one, it's totally humid. Two, I have 20 plus pounds on my back, and I used 20 pound weights today. Now, it's not about quantity, it's about quality, right? So feel free, you guys, you can do this all again. You can keep going, whatever it is that works for you. As you can see, my workout's probably done, but you know what? That right there is what makes it worth it, okay? You guys have a fantastic day. Thanks for hanging out with this impromptu, realistic view of my day. See you next time.